Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today we're taking a look at the Dell PowerEdge R750xa. This is a 2U system and that A on the end means it supports accelerators. In this case, up to 4 double-wide or 8 single-wide PCIe cards that are housed in the front of the system. Designed to handle accelerated workloads, the dual sockets are outfitted with 3rd generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, codename Ice Lake, that can provide up to 40 cores each. Hit that subscribe button if you want to see more server and workstation reviews. Let's get to it. Well, maybe this Dell PowerEdge R750xa server is a little late in coming, but I already did the R750 and the R750xs servers, one of which you can see here, and the other of which is in the description below. I wanted the full trifecta, and this will complete the trilogy. We recently ordered the R750xa for a customer, and since we have it, I thought we might take a look at it together. If I was to compare these platforms to a film, it would be more like The Hobbit than the Fellowship of the Ring trilogy. I mean, how did they extend that little Hobbit book, you know, out into 3 movies? Still, all the same platform, same book too, so I'm going with The Hobbit. Each of the R750 platforms offers a slightly different features to ensure a good fit for a particular workload and budget. The Dell PowerEdge R750xa server is more purpose-built for GPU support than, say, the R750. It's designed to tackle AI, AI inference, AI training, and machine learning and deep learning. It can also be used for applications in entertainment and media, plus database analytics and virtual desktop infrastructure. There is an optional bezel for this system, and I do like Dell's aesthetic. With several units squeezed together, it's like a hive for those gigantic bees from Jules Verne's Mysterious Island. Behind the bezel, there are 8 drive bays right in the middle that provide options for SAS, SATA, and NVMe. With only 4 storage configurations, it's either up to 8 SATA SAS SSDs in a RAID, up to 8 NVMe in a RAID, 4 SAS SATA in a RAID plus 4 NVMe direct attached, and lastly, up to 6 NVMe direct attached storage devices. You cannot add any more drive bay cages to the front of the system as those perforated panels to either side of the central drive bay have upfront GPUs. Those GPUs benefit from the freshest, coolest air that's pulled into the chassis instead of the DRAM-scented preheated air they would normally bathe in if the GPU cages were located at the back of the chassis. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R750xa server with Beehive-inspired bezel design? If you are, then for a limited time, you could save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. That's right. Just click that link to learn more, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. That's it. Sales guys are standing by. There is a left and right control panel. The one on the left features the system health, system ID, status LED, and the optional integrated Dell Remote Access Controller or iDRAC QuickSync 2 wireless indicator, only on certain models. iDRAC with QuickSync works with the OpenManage mobile app and can be used with iOS or Android smartphones or tablets. The right control panel has power, a USB port, iDRAC Direct micro port, and an iDRAC Direct status LED light. There's also a VGA port for connecting a monitor. On the rear panel, the PSUs are at opposite sides of the chassis, presumably for airflow, but also to minimize cable clutter, with power distribution units connected to separate UPS units, potentially located on either side of the server rack. There are several PSU options depending on your power needs once you configure the system. You will definitely be installing the 2400 watt or 2800 watt options if you go with a full complement of high performance GPUs. The perforated panels above each of the PSUs support the paddle cards to connect the upfront GPUs to the PCIe 4.0 lanes. The optional boot optimized storage subsystem, or BOS, is located right next to the 2 top PCIe slots. Those PCIe slots can be used to support high speed network cards. On the lower portion of the chassis, there optionally could be a USB 2.0 port, serial port, USB 3.0 port, 2 RJ45 ports, and a VGA port. If this system is set up with optional liquid cooling, that VGA port would be replaced with the input-output tubes. A small form factor OCP 3.0 mezzanine card can be installed to add more network connections that won't take up any of the limited PCIe slots. Management of this system is through iDRAC 9.0 with lifecycle controller, and we made a short video here. Access is through iDRAC Direct, QuickSync 2 wireless mobile application for smartphones or tablets, and there's also the option to install the iDRAC service module. The iDRAC service module is a software add-on that's easy to download and will provide even more information that can be shared with the host OS. That said, it is another application running on the OS and may take up some additional resources, but it will also provide more data for management. There's also the Dell OpenManage utility. iDRAC is the one-to-many application, while Dell's Open Managed Suite is for the one-to-many, and will provide a full overview of your network in addition to other plugins like the Power Manager, Support Assist, and Update Manager. The system also offers full compatibility with Microsoft, VMware, ServiceNow, Ansible, plus many others. The interior is a thing of beauty to behold once you remove the cover. Everything is densely packed and neatly arranged with a modular layout featuring color coding and little diagrams describing how things are taken apart. That said, it's also kind of like a high-end Lamborghini in that you might have to drop the engine to change the oil. In this case, accessing those GPU cages in front is somewhat of a task. The cabling from those GPUs is also something to reckon with as they pass through the center of this cooling shroud and over the memory modules and CPUs. Some of the cabling passes under the air shroud too. Still, it's not like you're going to disassemble this system all the time. Usually if a server doesn't break down in the first 24 hours, you're good to go. I'm not sure you can say the same for a Lambo. With support for 2 3rd generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, this platform can be outfitted with CPUs with up to 40 cores each. Each CPU also supports 8 memory channel architecture and up to 64 PCIe 4.0 lanes for up to 128 PCIe 4.0 lanes total with both processors installed. That said, this is a dual-root system with each processor supporting half the memory and PCIe lanes on this platform. That includes those upfront GPUs. For most advanced features and up to 40 cores, you will be going with the Platinum Series Scalable Processor option. Gold Series CPUs max out at 32 cores, and Silver Series will provide up to 20 cores plus a reduced top memory speed of up to 2667 MHz. That compared to memory speeds for Platinum and Gold, which will provide up to 3200 MHz memory speeds, including configurations with 1 or 2 DIMMs per channel. In addition to registered and load-reduced DIMMs, this system does support Intel Optane 200 series memory modules offering up to 6 terabytes of memory using a combination of DDR4 DIMMs and 512 gigabyte persistent memory modules. 3DS LR DIMMs will provide half that memory complement at up to 3 terabytes of memory using 256 gigabyte memory modules. Our DIMMs a bit less as the 3DS versions offering greater DRAM density is not supported, nor are unbuffered DIMMs. With Intel Optane, which I will add seems to be on its way out, there are 2 options, well, actually 3, when configuring Optane memory modules. Memory mode treats Intel Optane memory modules like DRAM modules, and that's where you would get the full 6 terabytes. In memory mode, the memory, just like RDIMMs and LRDIMMs, is treated as volatile and cannot be managed by the OS. It's not quite as fast as DRAM, but is still quite fast. AppDirect mode treats memory as persistent, which in this case presents itself as a block device in the OS. The RDIMM or LRDIMM memory that is used in combination with Optane is still used as main memory for the system. The interesting part is you can actually use it for a regular file system or to boot the OS. With that option, you would not even need any drives installed. Using memory modules as a storage medium also places the data close to the processor for faster queuing. Lastly, mixed mode, which is a combination of the two and uses DRAM for hot data and persistent memory for warm data. Those PCIe slots in back, of which there can be up to 8, provide options for expansion of the system capabilities. Up to 6x16 slots and 2x8 slots, all PCIe 4.0, and that includes the x8 OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot. Concerning the upfront drives, there are a number of RAID options presented by Dell's PERC 15G and 14G controllers. In the Dell R750xa, there is a dedicated spot right behind the backplane, again helping to preserve those limited PCIe slots in back, just like the OCP card. For that OCP card, there are choices too. Depending on what kind of PCIe bandwidth you might have after deciding on appropriate GPUs and I/O cards, you can choose from a Dell Network Daughter card, OCP 2.0 LOM mezzanine card, or OCP 3.0. Only the Dell Network Daughter card will take up a x8 Gen 3 PCIe lane. The other 2 OCP options say they need a x16 interface and PCIe 3.0 or PCIe 4.0, respectively. Snap I/O network interface controller for PCIe slots will provide a balanced I/O configuration for both CPUs without taking up to 2 PCIe slots with 2 separate I/O NICs assigned to each CPU. A snap card will automatically split the traffic between the processors. External storage is supported, and that includes NAS, IDM, and JBOD, or just a bunch of disks, with a connection to one of the Dell's PowerVault ME484 appliances or some other storage enclosure. 4 GPU cages in the front of the system support either 4 full-height, full-width, high-performance graphics or accelerator cards, or up to 8 single-width cards. As I said earlier, those GPUs are connected to GPU risers in front, which in turn connect to the cables you see running down the center of the air shroud, and then to paddle cards mounted in the risers to either side. There are a bunch of accelerators supported from both NVIDIA, which has the lion's share, and AMD. All of these cards, well, especially at the higher end, are targeted at AI applications. However, those single-width cards will also provide the juice to deliver on those AI applications and graphics-intensive workloads. For applications in AI, machine learning, deep learning, and in general, GPU-intensive workloads, the Dell PowerEdge R750xa offers a great deal of flexibility in a tightly packed configuration. Dual third-gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, up to four double-wide high-performance GPUs, or eight single-width cards, support for up to 3 terabytes of standard DRAM modules, or up to 6 terabytes using Intel Optane 200 series persistent memory, plus flexible storage configurations, all in 2U. It can deliver the performance your applications crave. Anyways, if you like this video, give it the thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. If you want more information on this system, or if you're just looking for some upgrades or hard to find components for your existing network, I placed a few links below, or you can use that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.